Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel AJ Electrical. My name is James Kutty Thomas, retired electrical inspector from Kerala. In this channel, I am handling the topics of electrical safety, lightning protection, solar PV installations, etc. Today, I like to explain about earthing configuration, TN, TT and IT. But it is difficult to explain the whole topic within a video, so you can expect some series of videos. Please cooperate with me. And for these topics, I am referring to the Indian Standards 732/2019 and 3043/2018. You can get both of these standards free of cost from BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards site. Okay, today I will be giving some basics before entering deep into the earthing configuration. Okay, let us move to the topic. For the utilization part of electricity, we will have a source and a load side or an insulation. The source can be either a transformer or it can be a generator or even a solar insulation or anything. Okay. So, for understanding about this earthing configuration, let us see the source as a transformer as shown in figure. It is delta connected and the secondary side star connected, and let it be a distribution transformer. So, the primary side voltage is 11 kV and secondary side 433 volt. Now, we are considering about the winding. It is delta connected and the other one star connected. Being star connected, there will be a star point, and the star point will be earthed. Okay. From the earthing point, from this earthing point, we are taking the neutral out. So three phases and one neutral can be there. For understanding or for further study about earthing configuration, we like to simplify this diagram into like this. The secondary side, I am drawing this star connection like this for easy understanding. Okay, so it is a three phase system, and from it we can extract a single phase with a single coil or a single phase. Okay, then about the earthing configurations, there are TNC, then TNCS, then TNS. I am just showing the diagrams, but we will take one by one into future classes. And IT, TNC, then TNCS. You please note the letters there. T, N, or C, then S, then both T, then on I is in the source side, and T is in the other side. We will take every letter for detailed study. Okay. Now, here I am quoted some notations from our standard. You can see the earthing. See here, you see the heading there. Functional earthing and protective earthing. What is the meaning between them? We know, we heard about this functional earthing and protective earthing. At least some of you know the meaning or the difference in between them. But see here, from the word itself, we can get the meaning. Functional earthing means it is for the function. And the other part is protective earthing means it is for protection. We know this transistor radio. There will be some printed circuit board there in the radio, or any electronic circuit. There will be a printed card, printed circuit board will be there. There will be a reference point, or let us take the case of a CT scanner. It will have a reference point, or any equipment will have a reference point. That reference point must be earthed for the function of the equipment. Got the point? There will be an earthing point which must be earthed not for the protection but for the function of the equipment, means reference point. So the earthing, suppose take the case of a single phase generator, there will be two wires. As per IS, we should earth one of the two wires. Then we call it as the earthed point is called as neutral point. So there we are taking one of the wires as a reference. That is what is called a reference point or for the function purpose. So that type of function type of or the earthing for the function purpose is called functional earthing, and the representation is like this. And for protective side, protection earth, protective earthing will be for the protection purpose, for suppose getting some protection, the body of the equipment will be earthed. It is not functional earthing. That is for the protection or the human handling the equipment, he should get the protection. So the earthing done for the purpose of protection is called protection earthing, and the other one is functional. Please note this regulation, safety regulation as per 16, regulation 16. It is said that the supplier should provide a suitable earth terminal to the consumer. But I am not sure whether we are getting such an earthed terminal. See, just below that, it is said that for the consumers having voltage exceeding 250 volt, means a three-phase consumers, they must have their own earthing arrangement in addition to the above earth terminal given by the supplier. Okay, means what's the meaning? What's the other part for those having voltage below or equal to 250 volt, they don't need to have independent earthing, means a single phase consumers. So as per this provision, it is said that single phase consumers are not compelled to have their own earthing arrangement, means the earthing given by the supplier is enough. But for the three phase consumers, in addition to the earthing given by the supplier, they must have their own earthing arrangement. See, below that, another provision is there. It is said that if the licensee is finding the consumer's earthing arrangement is sufficient, they won't provide the earthing from the licensee or from the supplier. I don't know the meaning. Actually, there is some mistake is there in this clause. So, during the draft discussion, for this safety regulation, there was a point that there is missing word is about the earthing configuration. Throughout this regulation, the earthing configuration, whether it is TN or TT or IT, that must be specified in this regulation. So we can expect that correction. Okay, just shown you about the requirement of the earthed terminal from the supplier. Okay, what is the purpose of earthing? I told you about functional earthing and protective earthing. The functional earthing is done for the better function of the equipment. For example, some medical equipments, CT scanner or X-ray or any other equipment, there will be some reference point. Only when we earth the reference point, it will work properly. But here, suppose the source, I have shown you a transformer here. We are earthing the neutral. See here, we earthed the neutral. So what will be happening there? We are making the earth as reference. So the electrical source, we take on reference point. Earthing is done for making the earth as reference point. Thereby, we will get single phase voltage. Is it? So one purpose of earthing is to get a constant single phase voltage. The other purpose is to make a low impedance swap path for any faults. Suppose consider an equipment, it is having a metal enclosure that must be earthed. By earthing that, what will happen? See here, I have shown an equipment, its body is earthed. Is it? By, see, through this earthing, it is getting into contact with the neutral of the source. So if there is a fault, that fault current will run to the source. So by neutral earthing, we are creating a path for the flow of fault current. Thereby, what will happen when it is passing to the source, the overcurrent protection or the residual current is RCD or RCCB, that will work depending upon the fault current. Got it? Here I generally explained about earthing. Now we shall move into protective earthing. Hereby we are leaving that functional earthing part. We are concentrating upon protective earthing only. What is mean by protective earthing? For the protection of the human or the equipment, we will earth the frames, fencing or enclosure or anything related with an installation. Okay, that will be earthed. See here, this equipment body is earthed, and through the earthing conductor, it is getting into contact with the neutral of the source, and the fault current will be passing through the earthed part. So the earthed conductor should be able to carry the fault current. Should be able to carry the fault current up to the duration of tripping of the system or the safety devices, OCPD or RC. Okay, that's about protective earthing. Now, for the better understanding of earthing configuration, we need to understand about some basic terms. The first term is pen conductor or protective earthed neutral, means a conductor in which the combined functions of both protective conductor and neutral conductor, means the same conductor will act as protective conductor and neutral conductor. That is what is called a pen conductor. That we will study later in detail. See, now about what is protective conductor. Protective conductor means, see here, all this belongs to protective conductor. I told you about the frames or fencing or etc. Connected with an insulation should be earthed. That all belonging to protective conductor. See, exposed conductive parts, extraneous conductive parts, or main earthing terminal, or shortly it is called MET. We will study in detail about MET. So MET is also a protective conductor. Then earthed point of the source or an artificial neutral. Actually, artificial neutral means it is not the natural neutral. We are making it neutral by earthing. That is why it is called as artificial neutral. So that earthing is also belonging to protective conductor. Now about protective equipotential bonding. Equipotential bonding means different parts of a system will be, or the extraneous parts will be interconnected to a main terminal. So that is what, that process is called equipotential bonding. Means interconnecting, say you know about earth bus, that is the same as MET, main earthing terminal. So that interlinking for getting the same potential throughout the system, we will do the process of equipotential bonding. That is what is called protective equipotential bonding. Then the next term is PME or protective multiple earthing. We will study later about the TNCS system. In TNCS system, we are taking the neutral from the source, or we are connecting the neutral from the source to the earthing terminal of the installation. Got it? We are connecting the neutral of the source to the earthing terminal of the installation. Such a connection is called a protective multiple earthing. We will study in detail about that one later. See, next word is conventional touch voltage limit. See here I have shown a person here. There will be some safe voltage in between the parts of his body. But when it reaches the touch voltage, means say it can be 50 volt or 40 volt, the touch voltage above which he will face the accident. That is called, that limit is called touch voltage limit. Then the next term is loop impedance, earth fault loop impedance. We will study about in detail about earth fault loop impedance later. See here, I have shown the figures. Then we will understand one more word, main earthing terminal. So I shall take the basic terms, earth fault loop impedance and MET later. See, just I gave you an introduction only about some basic terms I told you in this section. I took the references from the two IS standards, then National Electric Code, then some internet links. See, I understand that this basic portion to study in detail about earthing configuration is helpful to you. I generally given on some points only, and we will study in detail later. I understand that this information is suitable for you. Please share this one with your friends and get in touch with this channel. We will study in detail about earthing configuration later. Immediately, just after a few days, I will take the second part also. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and support me. And I appreciate you. I am telling thanks to you for sparing your free time and the patience for listening this information. Okay, let us see later with another video. Thank you.